this thing on? Oh yeah, there it is. Hey everybody, brewtubers. Look at what I got today. Got that in the mail from brewtubers.com. The Online Brewers Club. We'll talk about that in a minute. Right now, I'm pouring up Black Betty version 2. Got this from mainebrewguy from the online club. So it's been sitting a while. Let's go ahead and pour it up. I have noticed that there's definitely been a lack of carbonation in it. I don't know if that's my, I'm pretty sure that's my part. I mean, well, there's some that forms. But I mean, it's been sitting probably 2 weeks now. Yeah, and a little bit longer aging. Definitely strong. I can, for some reason, the IBUs are kind of high on it. I don't know why. And it tastes really big bitterness. But the alcohol level skyrocketing. I can taste a lot of alcohol in this. But really, this is truly my first black IPA that I've had. So, you know, I don't have really anything to compare it to. But it's good. Definitely not a session beer. I might drink like two or three of them and call it a night. Yeah, I can taste the alcohol in it. Anyways, happy Homebrew Wednesday, everybody. It's Tuesday. And I don't have to go back to work till Friday, so party for me. Let's see. Anyways, what's been going on in the week of brewing? Let's see here. Saturday night, I brewed a Maibock. It's, I guess you could say, a lager. I'm using Bohemian lager yeast by Y Yeast. It's 2124. I used two packs of them. And it's cold enough. It's like 40 some odd degrees outside. And it's going to stay like that for a long time. So I figure, you know what, I'm going to do my first lager. But I'm not lagering it. I'm using the lager yeast. I'm fermenting it in an ale temperature. 64 degrees. It's in my basement in the corner. Eventually it's going to start getting lower in temperature. So it'll be like, I'm hoping 60 degrees in the coldest part of the year. But it's the Bohemian lager from Y Yeast. And after watching Northern Brewers Brewing TV, I guess it's a clean fermenting yeast that you can do ale or lager. So I'm going to go ahead and do it. I seen how it looked. It looked pretty good. A little clear. It's a Maibock. It's going to sit in fermenter for approximately 3 weeks. And then I'm going to transfer it over into secondary. And I'm going to let it age. I'm going to let it sit there probably till April. And then I'm going to go ahead and put it in a keg. Because by that time I'll have my kegs. I'm going to keg it. I'm going to put it in the kegerator for another month. And I'm going to be ready to drink it in May. Yeah, May. Baby. So we'll see how it goes. It's going to be my first beer that I'm going to let age for a while. I mean, I've gotten pretty good at letting stuff sit in secondary, and I actually forget about it, so we'll see how it goes. I did use two Y Yeast Smack Packs, just because I just about got this done. Wow, that's a long cord. Just about got this done, I went ahead and made my stir plate. It's up and running. It works. The only problem is I did have a good magnet from my hard drive, from an old hard drive. Now all of a sudden it disappears. So I gotta go get another magnet. I got another hard drive that I'm gonna take apart. I looked at the hardware store to get an earth magnet. I don't feel like paying $20 for a magnet plus $20 in, you know, parts of labor when I could have just bought one. No, but it is fun. I like building my own stuff now. From the wort chiller to the, yeah, to the stir plate. Now I just gotta get I can't think. 2,000 milliliter flask for it. And I'll start making my own yeast, or I'm having brain fart today. Starting up my own yeast. There we go, yeast starter. I might even, with this Bohemian strand, I might even go ahead and wash that if it turns out good. If it does good ale-wise, ale temps, I'll just go ahead and I'll wash that yeast and I'll save it and probably put it through a couple battles. So other than that, I got 20 gallons of beer sitting in secondary, primaries, two in primary, two in secondary. Still haven't done the stout yet. I can't get myself to do it. I'll be bottling a couple times. Probably this coming weekend I'll be bottling. I should bottle the stout. And then I got the Sierra Nevada clone that's in secondary with a dry hop. So let's talk about this. Brewtubers. The website is brewtubers.com. I'm a member. My wife's a member. A lot of the home brewer community here is a member. The site has not officially been launched yet. It's still in, I guess you could say, testing. But the forums are up and going. Still probably a little bit of work that needs to be done to it, but right now, mainly, it's about 95% ready to go, at least the forum part. So I'll put the link down here. Go to brewtubers.com, sign up, subscribe, do follow the instructions, do what they say, become a member of Brewtubers. Once it gets going, I swear to God, it's going to be outstanding. We have a lot of people right now on forums. We're trying to get it up and going. And another thing I'm going to ask the community to do is, if you are a member of brewtubers.com, if you want to go ahead and put something on your intro that shows that you're a member. Because remember, guys, this is a online brewers club. If you can't get into a home brewers club, like I have three of them that I can be a member of, but I just don't have time. I can't go on Mondays and I can't go on Sundays just because of the family or, you know, work. It makes it hard for me to join these clubs. Here, I can sit my happy ass with a nice cold beer and be on the forums and sit here hours of chat time on the forums. As you go through there, there's going to be live chats, there's going to be online brew club meetings. So things are going to be convenient. So let's give it a shot, have everyone look at it, join it, subscribe, do what it says, and we can make this community huge. I'm going to put my intro, as you're probably already seen, when my opening page, I'm going to have it on there. So if you guys can post something that you're a proud member of brewtubers.com, that would be awesome. Let's spread the word around. Let's get this thing going. Let's make it bigger than some of these other forums that are around. So that's all I'm going to say today. I'm going to sit back. I'm going to enjoy this cold black IPA. Thanks again, Main Brew Guy, for the recipe. Ooh, I tell you what, it bites. It bites hard. It's good. It's gonna taste a little, or take a little bit for my palate to get used to that. So, happy Homebrew Wednesday. And see you next week. Drink hard and prosper. Yeah, I'm just gonna drink my beer. Talk to you later.